We've recently been working on some new updates to the Azure Database Migration Service. Learn all about it and see some cool demos of how to do a migration in the Azure portal from SQL Server to Azure SQL this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Abhishek, a member of the Azure SQL Migration product team. Abhishek, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Hello, Anna. Thanks for having me. This is my first time in your show, and I'm very excited about it. My name is Abhishek, and I'm working as a senior product manager in Azure Data Modernization team. This team is responsible for building different migration tools for customers to migrate their on-premises databases workload to Azure.
Awesome, cool. And today we're going to be talking about Azure Database Migration Service. Now, this is something some folks might be familiar with, some people might not. So I'd love if you could tell us a little bit about what is Azure Database Migration Service and what have you all been working on lately?
Sure. So to start with, Azure Database Migration Service, that is DMS, is a fully managed service designed to streamline the migration of SQL Server databases, whether they are running on on-premises or in other cloud environments. Previously, we can use DMS only via Azure Data Studio or Azure PowerShell CLI options, but now it can be used using Azure Portal as well. Currently, it is in public preview, but it allows you to create DMS service from Azure Portal itself or launch a migration from SQL Server on-premises to Azure SQL Target and many more.
Awesome, cool. It seems like something people have probably been asking to do. How easy is it to get started with DMS?
Yeah, it's super easy. Let me demonstrate quickly. So, this is the Azure Portal Studio, and if somebody would like to create a DMS service, all they need to do is click on Azure Database Migration Service. And to create a new service, they need to click on Create. Now here, they'll get options to choose their source type, which is going to be the SQL Server, their target type. They can choose either SQL VM, SQL MI, or SQL Database, and select the DMS service and move next. Now here they can provide their subscription, their resource group, the location where they want to create this service, and name of the service. So for this demo purpose, we are going to name it as demo data exposed -1 and just provide the tags. And click on Create.
Nice, super easy to get started, really.
Yeah. So in interest of time, I have already created a DMS service. As you can see, it's very convenient, and it directly gives you an option to start a migration, monitor an ongoing migration, or a migration which you have done in the past, and view your other properties of DMS service like integration runtime, et cetera.
Awesome, cool. Okay, so once I have this created, like then what do I do?
Okay, yeah. So now let's take an example where I would like to do a migration from SQL Server from on-premises to Azure SQL MI instance. So now let's take an example using this where we have already created the database service, and to start the migration, all we need to click on the new migration. Now select the source type, select the target type. In this example, I'm going to choose SQL MI. Provide the backup location because we will be using the backups of the source to restore. I have option to use Azure Blob Storage or Network File Share. If I choose Network File Share, it asks me to install the integration runtime for my DMS service. For this demo purpose, I have not installed it. Let's switch back to Blob Storage. It gives me an option to choose from the migration mode online or offline. To detail, to know more about this migration option, we have it defined under Katoa strategy under migration prerequisites. So let's choose offline and move forward. Now here it asks me to provide the subscription detail, the resource group, and it automatically select the MI instances present in this resource group. I go next. Now on the next screen, it asks me to provide the location of the blob storage where my backup resides. So I need to mention the resource group, storage account, and the blob container where I'm keeping my backups. Yeah. So it automatically takes, if you can see, the backups present in the blob storage.
Nice.
Now all I need to do is select this, and just to give you a demonstration, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this VM and this database. I've created a table, inserted few rows in it, and that's the backup I'm going to use, and restore it on this MI instance, which I've just refreshed. Now to go back, I put the name of the database on the target. Let's say for this demo-data-expose. And click next. Now here it presents me the summary. I can go through it, and once everything is okay, I can start the migration. As you can see, under migration tab, it shows me the status of the ongoing migrations. So if I want to know more, I can click on the resource name and it displays all the information related to my ongoing migration. On the right side, it displays me the target server version, the last backup file it restored, and the restoring file status. Now it may take some time.
And during this time, because this is an offline migration, during this time, if any changes, like I need to make sure my database is not, you know, accepting new transactions and that sort of thing, right?
Absolutely. You're right. That's why it's offline migration. So as we were speaking, it has already performed the restore. And if you see the status of these changes, all backup restored. So whatever the backups I have provided in that blob storage, all of them have restored successfully. And within a couple of seconds, it will go succeed. Yeah. As I can show it over here, it successfully completed. So if I refresh, it's changed the status on the dashboard as well. Yeah. So that's how one can migrate on-premises SQL Server to MI. Super simple, super easy using the DMS. Now awesome. Through Azure Portal as well.
Cool. That's super useful. Abhijay, thanks so much for sharing that demo with us. One question for you to follow up is, you know, we talked about how you showed us how you can use this to do an offline migration. If I wanted to do an online migration, is that something that DMS also supports?
Correct. So DMS support offline and offline, offline and online migration for both SQL MI as well as SQL VM. However, for SQL DB scenarios, it currently supports offline migrations only.
Awesome. Cool. Well, so this seems like it can be used for most of our migration needs. Folks can go ahead and get started with this. It's in public preview today. Any final tips and tricks for folks as they're getting started with the new DMS experience?
Yeah, give it a try. And I'm sure it will be able to successfully migrate your databases. If you face any challenges, there is a lot of documentation available on learn.microsoft.com, which I can provide the links for you. So happy testing.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Abhishek. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like. Check the links in the description. We'll put some links to Learn for you to go learn more about how to use Azure DMS to migrate to Azure SQL. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.